Hi everyone, my name is Pavitra V, Department of Chemistry. Today we are going to discuss a topic called TLC, Thin Layer Chromatography. Chromatography is actually a separating technique. Chroma means color, graphy means to write. So we are writing a color differentiation. So this is the glass slide on which silica gel is poured on like a uniform surface to form a stationary phase. So this silica gel plate is acts as a stationary phase. On that, the spots are plotted like this and dipped in a mobile phase or a suitable solvent. Then the spot differentiates like this. When the solvent moves upwards, this is the TLC plate which will looks like this, and you can cut into whatever shape you want, whatever the length or the width you want. And this is the TLC chamber. After the TLC is completed, it looks like this. Okay, come to the introduction. TLC is one of the simplest, fastest, easiest and least expensive of several chromatographic techniques used in the qualitative and quantitative analysis to separate organic compounds and to test the purity of the compounds. So the main features of chromatographic technique is separation of organic compounds and purity checking. Next, TLC is a form of liquid chromatography consisting of a mobile phase which is in the solvent and a stationary phase which is formed plate or a strip coated with a form of silica gel. Analysis is performed on a flat surface under atmospheric pressure and room temperature, that is your normal laboratory. Next, we come to the definitions. Thin layer chromatography can be defined as a method of identification of mixture of components into individual components by using finely divided adsorbent solid or a liquid spread over a glass plate and liquid as a mobile phase. Liquid is nothing but suitable solvent. Synonyms are the terms used: drop. Drop is nothing but spot marked on a plate or a TLC plate. Strip is a plate. Spread layer is the silica gel. Surface chromatography, actually it is a surface phenomena. And open column chromatography. Adsorption or retention or partition or both or any other principles of the substances on the stationary phase. So the spot or the mixture taken is adsorbed on the stationary phase, and when we run the mobile phase, it carried out in the mobile phase with a certain adsorption powers or the time required. Okay, next point, separation of the adsorbed substances by the mobile phase, recovery of the separated substances by the continuous flow of the mobile phase, that is elution. This process is called elution. And qualitative and quantitative analysis of the eluted substances. So the solvent or the mobile phase coming out from is called eluted substance. Okay, then principle of TLC. This is very much important. It is based on the principle of adsorption chromatography or partition chromatography or combination of both. Depending on adsorbent, its treatment and nature of solvent employed. See, the component with the components taken in the sample with more affinity towards stationary phase, then it travels slower. Components with less affinity towards the stationary phase, it travels faster. Let us consider a mixture having two components A and B. If component A is more affinity towards stationary phase and travels slower, and component B with the less affinity towards stationary phase and travels faster, so then component B is eluted first and component A is eluted next. So we can separate. The first component is separately collected in a beaker and the second component A is collected separately in another beaker. So this is the separation technique based on the affinity towards stationary phase. Next, when the TLC can be used. TLC is used if the substance are non-volatile or of low volatility. That means it should not be volatile. If it is volatile, when it put it on the TLC paper or the TLC plate, it gets evaporated. So you will not get an effective result. Next, the substances are strongly polar or medium polarity, non-polar or ionic. All these natured compounds can be used. A large number of sample must be analyzed simultaneously, cost effectively, and within the limit of period of time. Okay, takes lesser time when compared to other type of chromatographic technique. If the sample reacts or damages, destroys the liquid chromatography or gas chromatography columns, then we will use this TLC method. If a substance damages column in a gas chromatography or liquid chromatography, then we will use TLC method. If the solvent would attack the adsorbents in LC, then also we will use TLC. Whenever the column chromatography fails, we will use TLC. Okay, the substance in the material being analyzed cannot be detected by the methods of liquid chromatography and gas chromatography, or only with great difficulty. See, whenever a organic compound undergo any reactions with the mobile phase or stationary phase, or it destroys the column, then we could not find out the nature or separate the compounds in column chromatography. In that case, we will use this thin layer chromatography. After the chromatography, all the components of the sample have to be detectable. Okay, then only we can conduct this TLC. Next one is the component of a mixture of substances after separation have to be detected individually or have to be subjected to various detection methods one after the other. Okay, for example, in the case of drug screening, so TLC is not enough to in the drug screening, we have to use other techniques also. No source of electricity is available, so we will not use any electrical powers for the TLC method, so it can be carried out normally in a laboratory temperature and pressure, room temperature and pressure. Then we will move to the fields of application of thin layer chromatography. Over the years 1993 to 1994, since we are using this TLC in medicines, 26% of medicines, biochemistry, toxicology is the studying the effect of chemical reagents on a biological system, pharmacology, and in pharmacy or drug preparation, 25% of TLC methods, TLC is used. And then environmental and food for the purity checking or quality controls, and in chemistry for the organic reagents and other MISC TLC methods.